morning, Bulldogs. I'm Lola Moitoso, and welcome to Turlock Today. Are you interested in running for an ASB elected position? Well, now you can. Applications are available in the Activities Office. Positions include President and Vice President, Secretary, Treasurer, School Board Rep, and Spirit Leaders. Apply today to be a part of the ASB team in the 2022 through 2023 school year. Now here's Turlock Today reporter Julie McGinnis with a story on Bulldog Community Class that's finding a fun way to build community and excitement during BC time.
Recently, my colleague Marcus Mode and I searched for Bulldog community classes that are finding ways to build camaraderie and spirit during BC time. Mr. Rosengarth's Bulldog community class is one of those classes. Let's take a look.
Hi, my name is Esteban.
My name is Kaden.
This is Bookie, B-O-O-K-I-E. I am or was watching a Mario Kart tournament, and I'm having a lot of fun because I'm preparing for tomorrow, which is when I go into the tournament.
In my Bulldog community class, I am competing in a Mario Kart tournament.
I use whatever kart I think is going to go well with the race. And my favorite character is Donkey Kong, because monkey.
My favorite character to play is Toad, and I usually just use a bike. We have medals for first, second, and third place, and then first place gets a Mario Kart pillowcase.
My name is Mr. Rosengarth. I think games in general are just a good way for people to get to know each other. It's a nice way to do something that's you can feel comfortable easier, I think, with it. And so I put up a few things for them to do on a Google form, and they voted and wanted to do this one, and it's been a lot of fun. I think so. You know, we've got about half the class right now playing. You can kind of hear it in the background there. We've got about half the class playing, and the other half are watching and enjoying it. So I think everybody's involved in some way or another with it. Let the kids decide what they want to do. Don't force them into it. Just, you know, give some options and say, hey, what do you guys want to do? And let's do it, kind of a thing.
Chess Club is selling t-shirts and hoodies. If you're interested in buying one, contact Mr. Rosengarth in room R6. The deadline to order is March 9th. Want to increase deaf awareness and learn basic ASL? Join ASL Club on Tuesday, March 8th during lunch in room H4A. No prior knowledge of ASL is necessary. Juniors, interested in being part of the prom committee? Please see Mrs. Bromas in room H4A to sign up. Yesterday, we sat down with some members of THS Boys Golf to talk about their success so far this season and what it's like to play on the team.
What's up, dogs? I'm Kian Young, senior and captain of the Turlock High School golf team.
What's up, guys? My name's Clark Van Galen. I'm a sophomore, and this is my second year on the golf team.
And I'm Christian Maggard. I'm a freshman, and this is my first year on the golf team.
So, last Monday, we played at Merced Country Club. As a team, we won by 33 shots, and individually, I won shooting a 3-under-69, and this is our trophy.
Guys, our schedule is posted on the Turlock High School webpage, so make sure to check it out. And on April 27th, we play Pittman at Turlock Golf and Country Club, so make sure to clear your schedule and come out and watch us win.
If you're interested in playing golf, try out next year as a freshman, sophomore, or junior. Contact Jason Boswell, he's the best.
Yep, you guys can catch us on the course.
Hi, I'm Abby Mansonides with some more updates for Turlock Today. Congratulations to the speech and debate team for qualifying every one of their entries to the state tournament. Martin Berteo, Celeste Vargas, Kate Ogden, Danny Sanchez, Lindsay Huh, Lindley Fripp, Hanya Martinez, and Emma Cabral will all be attending the state tournament in April. Congrats again to the speech and debate team. Go Dogs! THS is having the first ever Bumpfest on March 18th. What's Bumpfest? Let's find out.
Do you love cars? Do you have a great sound system or an awesome engine that you think could be best at THS? Sign up to participate in our first ever Bumpfest on March 18th during lunch. A few of the categories for the competition include, but are not limited to, loudest, best sound system, loudest, best sounding engine, and the dirtiest vehicle. Teachers can sign up too. For details, check your advisement in Google Classroom.
Now, I know you're probably wondering what is Bumpfest, and I'm here to tell you. So basically, on March 18th, we're gonna line up all the cars, motorcycles, dirt bikes, anything you want at the tee. Three judges will come around and judge your vehicle based on what categories you select in your application, and winners will be announced. So please join and show off your vehicle, dirt bike, motorcycle, anything you want.
Applications are due March 11th.
Don't forget to sign up.
Let's head outside for a Bulldog weather report from our very own Sophia Estrada.
It's cold.
Thanks, Sophia. Now it's time for everyone's favorite segment, Fire Fit Fridays. Who will be nominated this week? Let's find out.
Flavy Fit Friday.
Your guys' Flabies were nominated for Flavy Fit Friday. How do you guys feel about that?
I feel pretty good.
I'm honored. I'm glad that his outfit was picked out for this.
Can you guys explain your Flabies fits?
Okay, he has on a striped shirt today with some green pants. This is an outfit I've had in mind for a while. I made sure to plan out all his outfits for every single day. So it's honestly an honor to be nominated.
For mine, I really just had this outfit in one of my dolls, and I was like, you know what? It has a gender, and it was a girl, so I was like, I'll just put this on. So yeah.
All right. What inspired your guys' Flabby to wear this?
For me, what inspired me to put this on my Flabby was just the gender. Like, it was a girl, and I was like, well, I'll just find something that one of my dolls has. So it was this, and I just put this one on.
He really likes stripes, so I put some stripes on him, and then green was one of his favorite colors, so I thought stripes and green would go together.
All right, that's great. Thank you, guys.
Thank you.
Your Flabby has been nominated for Flabby Fit Friday. How do you feel?
Honestly, not surprised. My Flabby always dripping.
Would you care to explain your Flabby's fit?
Yeah, so my baby, Kylie. So we got this sick button-up shirt. It says ride or die. You got tigers, you got motorcycles, you got flames, you got it all red and blue. And then for the hat, it says daddy, because daddy.
Your Flabby was nominated for Flabby Fit Friday. How do you feel about that?
I saw him, he chose his clothing, so it was like, I'm gonna let him do his thing, you know?
Can you describe his fit?
Just the beanie. I used the beanie for his clothing, and then, you know, we got a match together, so I put a red hat on him, so, you know, just something simple, something light.
What inspired you to dress your Flabby like this?
I was wearing red today, so, you know, we got a match, you know, so just something to go with my fit, too.
Your Flabby has been nominated for Flabby Fit Friday. How do you feel?
I feel great. I didn't have time to change my baby today, so kind of embarrassed about that, but kind of fun.
Can you describe your Flabby's fit?
Sure. This is a shirt that I got from my criminal investigation class. I'm proud to say that is one of the best classes that I've taken in my since sophomore year, I believe. It's a really fun class, so he's representing it today.
You've been nominated for Fire Fit Friday. How do you feel?
Yeah, I'm surprised. I'm surprised, you know? I go with whatever I'm feeling that day, you know? Today, got the Calvin Klein jeans on, Costco. Got me some Chuck Taylors. I believe socks, because I like to believe. This Eddie Bauer jacket right here, $40 sale, Costco. Sporting the Bob Marley shirt today, you know, I figured I'd wear it. Got this Target, it's really soft. I feel honored, you know. I don't look as good as all you guys though, so, you know, I'm okay with losing.
What about your hat?
Well, my hat, this is straight vintage Osborne, you know, Osborne, do you know what they are? The Osborne Lions maybe or something?
I don't know either,
I don't remember. But my kids went there learning Spanish, so yeah. So yeah, just trying to represent Turlock.
The Turlock Today crew explored pop culture and asked students and staff on campus their thoughts on last month's Super Bowl halftime show. Here's what they said.
What's your name and grade?
My name is Isabel Magana, and I am a senior.
What was your favorite singer this year?
This year, you know, probably Snoop Dogg. He's a classic. Love that guy.
What's your name and what's your grade?
My name's Alex and I'm a sophomore.
What was your favorite part?
Favorite part was when Snoop Dogg started crip walking on me.
What's your name and grade?
Matthew and Tint.
Okay, so what was your favorite part of the Super Bowl?
When Cooper Kupp caught the winning touchdown.
What's your name and what grade are you in?
My name's Taylor Holzapple and I'm a freshman.
What do you think about the Super Bowl halftime performance?
It was good. That was like one of my favorite performances.
And who were you cheering for during the Super Bowl?
The Rams.
What is your name and role on campus?
My name is Mr. C and I'm a student teacher.
What was your favorite part about the halftime show?
My favorite part about the halftime show is definitely when Snoop Dogg was doing his dance across the stage. That was pretty cool.
Then who were you cheering for during the Super Bowl?
I was cheering for the Bengals just because I like Joe Burrow and most of my friends are Rams fans, but I don't like the Rams.
Hey Bulldogs, Ella here from Mr. McElroy's Bulldog Community Class in EW1, and we have a challenge for you. Remember the mannequin challenge? Well, we're bringing it back. Check out our video, then grab your BC classmates and see if you can do it better. You have until Tuesday, March 15th to email your videos to Ms. Coulomb to enter. Good luck.
Yesterday, we sat down with some members of THS Boys Golf to talk about their success so far this season and what it's like to play on the team.
So, last Monday, we played Rosengarth Country Club, and I literally just forgot my line.
It was bound to happen sometime.
It's bad. It's okay. It's good. LOL. I don't know what else to say.
For my friend and auntie Lola Moitoso, I'm Abby Mansoyes. Over and out, Bulldogs. See you next time on Turlock Today.